Ben ritrovati a questo speciale di Classi NBC dedicato al mondo dell'agricoltura, di come sta cambiando anche alla luce delle nuove sfide, i cambiamenti climatici e ancora la competizione, il processo di concentrazione nell'industria. Ho il piacere di ospitare con me oggi nei nostri studi qua a Classi NBC Eric Fearwald, il CEO di Syngenta. Sir, it's very good to have you here. Thank you very much.
Buongiorno, Carlo.
First of all, I would like to briefly discuss with you the results of the first half of 2019. The overall sales for your group were at $6.8 billion. So yes. Overall, how would you define such results?
It was a little bit disappointing because it was slightly down versus prior year, 2%. But all of that decrease and much more is explained by one country, and that's the United States, where there has been record flooding, the most flooding in the large agriculture area in the history of the United States. So climate change is having an impact on agriculture. We saw it in the first half of the year in the United States in a big way. But now the weather is starting to dry up and the United States is picking up again. So I expect us to return to growth in the second half.
So it was due to external causes mainly, right?
Due to weather specifically in the United States, massive flooding.
Now, let's talk about a little bit more where Syngenta is going, your innovation program. You have, on a regular basis, brainstorming with your stakeholders. You have discussion where the company should go, which objective you should aim at. And could you elaborate on that, on why is it important to discuss the in and day out with your stakeholder, the whole philosophy of your company?
Yes, it's very important because we spend more than $1.3 billion a year on innovation, on research and development. And we want to make sure that that's targeted in the right places for both farmers, food companies, and consumers. So we're out listening to NGOs, government regulators, food companies, consumers, farmers, everybody around what they want to see in sustainable agriculture and food production. So what we're learning is that in addition to making sure that we're bringing out higher products that improve the yields for farmers and so reduce the cost and make sure that there's high quality food and safe food, both for the farmers and consumers, we also are being asked to challenge ourselves to make products that increase the sustainability of agriculture. So not only increase the yields, but reduce the amount of carbon dioxide that's emitted from agriculture, keep more carbon in the soil, for example, increase production so that we can not only reduce deforestation, but eliminate deforestation and start reforesting. Things that matter to consumers around addressing the critical issues of climate change.
Yeah, so you have already touched upon this topic, your innovation push is articulated in three different objectives. One of them is the innovation oriented to reduce the impact on environment, then you have a reduction of deforestation and so on and so forth. Could you give us more details on how you practically spend your money on R&D and then innovation?
Yeah, so we spend our money in R&D in three key areas. One is in seeds, so making the seed strengthen the plant so the plant is strong enough to grow healthy, high quality food and resist diseases and insects that the best that the plant can do. And then to complement what we do with the genetics of the plant, we provide crop protection products, pesticides that protect the plant. They're like medicines that help the plant when diseases get into the plant or get on the plant, fight the disease or fight the insects that are trying to eat the plant, which then allow diseases into the plant, and fight the weeds that battle the plant for nutrients. So we keep developing products that enhance the ability of the plant to defend itself and also to protect the plant.
Now, how advanced have we become in such era? You have become, Syngenta has become in such eras, because it's always an ongoing fight, new kind of bacteria emerge, new kind of diseases could affect plants. It's always, you don't win forever, right?
Right, so you have to keep coming out with new technologies to battle, just like in medicine. You know, with human diseases, you have to keep developing new medicines to protect people. We have to keep coming out with new medicines for the plant, but also new genetics for the plant to do better by itself. And as the plant is able to do better by itself, one of the things that's really nice is helping farmers to improve the health of the soil, to allow the plant, once you take out the corn or the wheat, more of the residue from the plants to go into the soil, increase the carbon in the soil. And that way you take the carbon out of the atmosphere and you help reduce climate change. That's a huge opportunity. Not only healthier soil for better plants and better food production, but also reduce the impacts of climate change. That's the great opportunity we have with smart use of modern agriculture technologies.
Now, the intensity, the severity of climate change has intensified in the past years. You are here in Europe and we are in the midst of a second record heat wave,
yes,
which is totally unusual for Italy and Central Europe as a whole. So have you changed partially the way you conceive your product, the way you develop your product, you supply your customers, due to the worsening conditions of the weather in the last 2 or 3 years?
Yes. So we're producing products, new products. We're developing new products with new technology to allow the farmers to better deal with massive climate changes, massive weather changes. So seeds, for example, that perform well even under drought conditions. And also now we have to have seeds that perform well under flooding conditions, because the farmers are seeing such dramatic shifts that what we're doing is making the seeds and the technology, the agronomic advice that we provide farmers, the digital imaging that we look at their fields, the ability to help the farmers deal with any climate change issues and be able to still grow crops, make a profit, high quality food, safe food, but at the same time also do it in a way that reduces the impact on climate change. So help deal with climate change, but at the same time reduce the impact of farming on climate change.
How about your customers? Are they responsive to the issue of climate change, or you have to, let's put it this way, educate them that it's not only about how much a crop yields on a yearly basis?
And what's fascinating is historically, we dealt mainly with farmers, and we worked with farmers to improve their yields. Now, increasingly, we keep working with farmers who, by the way, care a lot about their land, their production, and the sustainability of what they do. But also increasingly, we work with the agriculture value chain, the food value chain, with food companies, with agriculture commodity companies, all the way down to the consumer, and try to make sure that the whole value chain, even working with NGOs and government regulators, how do we make the whole system more sustainable? So one example is keeping more carbon in the soil during farming. Another is reducing food waste. So producing tomato seeds that create tomatoes that have a longer shelf life. So you don't throw away as much tomatoes, you reduce the waste. That reduces the carbon footprint of the food chain. So working that entire food chain and collaborating with players all across to reduce the total impacts of the agriculture food value chain on climate. Actually, going from contributing to climate change to being part of the solution to climate change.
Lastly, on this very important topic, especially this year, the public opinion has developed a different perception as far as plastic is concerned. Everywhere,
yes,
big companies are trying to reduce the amount of plastic that they use. Have you taken some actions in this regard?
Yes, we're taking actions both with our products. So many of our products are sold in plastic containers, and we have active programs to recycle those containers to make sure that they're clean and recycled, so part of the circular economy. And then within our company, we're reducing plastic waste. And one example is, in our headquarters, we don't use plastic bottles anymore. We have glass containers, and we use tap water instead of having lots of plastic bottles. That was a suggestion and an insistence from our employees that we have to do more to reduce our impact on the environment, and plastics was one area where we could make some difference.
Lastly, to wrap up this interview, I'd like to reflect upon What has changed for the company that you are guiding after the ChemChina acquisition? It was back in February 2016, 3 years later. How this acquisition has helped to improve, change the long-term goals and ambitions of your company?
Yeah, what's fantastic about the ownership of ChemChina, and they're a financial owner, is that they've allowed us to stay a Swiss-based, very global company. And we try hard as a global company to be an Italian company in Italy, an American company in the US, a French company in France, so very global, and they've allowed us to continue that. They've also allowed us to continue to invest heavily in innovation. So product innovation, digital innovation, allowing us to do more to help farmers and food companies produce better food sustainably. And then thirdly, and very importantly, they're helping us to improve our position in China. China agriculture has had huge challenges with soil health, overuse of fertilizer, overuse of old bad pesticides, water contamination. We're in China now helping farmers to clean up the soil, to significantly reduce fertilizer use, dramatically reduce pesticide use, use modern pesticides that aren't impacting the water, that are safe, and allowing for higher quality foods, but also protecting the environment in China, which also helps protect the environment in the world. The really great thing about ChemChina is they have allowed us to do what we need to do all around the world without interfering. So we stay really global company, but helping us to step change agriculture in China.
Well, sir, thank you. Thank you very much for this conversation. It has been nice to have you here on Classy NBC. Thank you again.
Grazie.
È tutto dunque per questo speciale. Grazie per averci seguito. Noi vi lasciamo agli approfondimenti del canale. Arrivederci.